great honor to be here. For one reason, and the one reason is that today is exactly the first birthday of Iron Scott.
Yeah!
One year old! Exactly 1 year old! Ready for me! Iron Scott had a premiere at the Friedrichshain Stars Palace, and it was an amazing event. I don't know if some of you were there, I knew that some of you are there, some of you were not, but it was an amazing event, the most proudest moment in my life. And now, 1 year later, I'm back and I'm so happy to present you guys with the team who made it possible to make this awesome film. So I want you all to put your hands together for following people. The producer of Iron Sky, celebrate the 1 year of Iron Sky. Happy birthday, Iron Sky! To be honest, the film was finished 48 hours before its premiere in Berlin, so had to rush it. And in the very last moment, we had to take out some stuff that was really cool, but it was not completely finished, and we didn't want to obviously not put it in a film and theaters everywhere. So now we've had one good full year to actually, how do you say, like, finalize whatever cool stuff there was. And I'm so happy to be able to present it to you. And one important part, obviously, is Joel guys from Tampere, Finland, doing a lot of visual effects. But there's a lot of other stuff. So I wish you enjoy and watch it all the way to the end. I know there's a long end credits, but it's, the film doesn't end there. So after all the credits are rolled and all that, then we will come on stage and we're more than happy to answer your Q&As. But I'd like to do one Q&A for you guys. How many of you have seen Iron Sky before this evening? Thank you. Now, how many of you have seen Iron Sky twice before this evening? Three times? Four times? Five times? So, I think this is a wonderful moment for all of us to thank you all for your 1 year long support. Please continue that. And we'll be back here for your Q&A after the show. Now, enjoy Iron Sky and Red Dog Swap! Same movie, but able to bring it there. And I think it was pretty nice. And now is a good time for all of us, all of you, actually, to ask questions from us. And you know, I have just this little bubble of wine, so I'll be very expensive. But these people will also answer. So whatever questions, we are at your disposal. Who's the brave first one? Right there in the middle.
Is this movie to theaters or not?
Director's not version. It is not what? Actually, first of all, this was screened from the Blu-ray. And it has been meant more not going to the big screen. But when I was watching it now, I think they might try to organize something. Let's definitely worth for another round, you know, maybe 2 hours. Okay, next question, my friends. Come on, we came all the way from the beginning. We have Australians, we have Julia here, we have Germans, we have a Tim, so feel free to ask questions. Yes, sir.
How can you do
There was a bit of a pressure there. We were invited to show this film at Berlin Film Festival, which is the best place to ever show this film. And we were sort of like, we realized that, okay, now if we really want to push this out, we have to do it. So we decided that we were a little bit out of underfunded and stuff like that. So we decided that, okay, now we're going to take a couple of things out and make it a whole package. And I think it works really well as a theatrical version. But bringing this back, I see it as a different version. I see it as sort of, it's a bit more epic on the pacing. I don't say which one is better or worse or whatnot, but I think that it's a little bit different version, so this is a different thing. But had we had more time, we probably would have brought at least parts of this back. Maybe there were some things that I brought there back because I just felt like it.
It was anyway, such a big dream to get the film to Berlin, and the information, confirmation from Berlin Panorama gave up actually really late. But it was a tough decision. We just have to get the film there.
So this is the kind of decisions we make. But yeah, we have a good excuse to sort of do it twice. Let's have another question, my friends.
A few German survives. So what do you plan for the second part?
So can you ask me, if
what do you plan for the second
part? What do I plan for the second part? Yeah, that is a question, and I would love to tell you, but I would have to kill you. So I'd rather leave your life. No, it's I just had a really good meeting with a couple of you, actually a few meetings, with Johanna, who's the writer, one of the writers, and you know, the team in Finland. We sat down and sort of we let it loose after 1 year of sort of things popping up into our head, and it's been very interesting discussions, and the story is going to be even crazier than this one. So, Julia, what do you think?
I love that version.
What do you see? I mean, you see it for the first time. Was there something in the original version that you were happy to see in this version?
Definitely. For example, sorry, probably we can already, probably not. For example, the first interrogation or the first meeting with Washington and Renata is much longer in this one. I prefer that one actually. And a lot of stuff, a lot of CGI it's really, really incredible, I think. And a lot of stuff that I actually forgot that I was acting. It's such a long time ago. So it was a surprise.
Yeah, do you like the Klaus singing part? That's beautiful. That was a romantic move. Now, okay. Let's go for more questions. I'm seeing this one.
My question is, will there ever be a Blu-ray version of Star Wars The Beginning?
Thank you. Star Wars The Beginning, which is my first film, which I did in 2005, which was another 7 years browsing. You can find it online. Just go over to, I don't know, somewhere, Google it, you should find
it's, I think it's full feature, it's on YouTube as well. So it's a Star Trek parody, just to give you some sort of background. Unfortunately, bringing it up to Blu-ray, it's going to be a bit more troublesome because we shot it on a DV cam, so pushing it up to Blu-ray will require a little bit more work. But I've been thinking about it. And, you know, we've been thinking about revisiting that too. But I think that's a problem, or sort of a possibility, a problem also with your digital, well, sort of the Lucas problems, that you always want to better your work. So in that way, yeah, why not? I mean, Star Wars, why not? Who knows? But, you know, I'd rather spend the time making a sequel to Star Wars.
Yeah. What are your plans for, do you have any more plans for more crowdsourcing like you did on this one? Or do you have something other as far as financing goes?
Maybe they don't have to talk about more about that.
I mean, crowdsourcing, definitely we continue to work together with people, and what comes to financing, in many ways we are going to continue it, and we'll see how. I mean, it was very complicated, all this interesting thing that we did with this film, legally and so forth, and there's some new regulations, and we have to look how the world looks when we are a bit further down the line.
But by definition, the basic experience was so good that there is no sort of actual reason why not to. But, you know, it depends on the nature of the project. Well, one thing is for sure that the crowdsourcing, the crowd participation is going to be something that we will continue now in the future. That's the other question. What else?
In the credits, I noticed that there was a body of Renate Richter. I mean, what did this body do? What's the left?
I'm going to have to break your heart. I think if you, even you didn't know, this is this person is actually present here right now, but I think she preferred to stay in secrecy. But it was about another which we brought with us to New York. We shot a couple of back shots of Renate in New York, we didn't have any money or permissions to go to New York, so we had to do it really very well. I remember the New York shoot was funny, where we had a camera, me and cameraman, and this other one, we were sort of running around Times Square without permissions, and we always saw that there's a police coming from there, but it has to go through a lot of crowd. So basically, we were just moving like this all the time, escaping police. It's not like we're doing something, it seemed like we were just some crew, so they were not in a hurry, but they were just, you know, coming through, so we did that for 40 minutes, and then we ran away. Because I can assure you, there is nothing in this world. There is nothing more expensive than shooting in New York. Nothing. You are proper shooting. The unions and oh God, it would be expensive. Kathy, would you like to say a few words? What did you think of this version of Iron Sky?
I really enjoyed it. Actually, it was really nice to be able to bring back some of the things that we lost. I think it. Of the humorous lines that we regret losing because we had to structure things around differently what we had script, we managed to bring some poetry back in, which we all in. So that was good. And I'm not sure if everybody there recognised the tramp in the alleyway at all.
Oh, yeah.
The tramp in the alleyway.
I said my line was We didn't reshoot anything. So basically everything we did insert that there was at least a very ugly storyboard of it existing, so we were able to sort of prove ourselves that this was the original plan. So basically, this is all following the original plan, so we didn't come there at the end, I want to fix this, but this was all sort of planned in the beginning. And we were sort of quite adamant about that because we wanted to make some, I don't want to end up in a situation where every half a year every film is being updated like a computer program somehow. It is. That would be a new version of, I don't know, Taxi Driver 2.0, 2.5 released today.
Yes, I have a question.
I saw a trailer for your new movie, Jeremiah Hahn.
Yeah.
And that's Julia Dietz that play in it, because I really love her performance.
Me too. And this I wouldn't want to go, we honestly, we have not been as far in casting as we would know, but I'm definitely going to be working with Julia in the future, let's just say that. Yeah, I'll take her to Paris and I kill her. I'm not going to film for Paris, I kill you. I kill you. As I'm doing the same thing there, so. It's nice though, it's horror, 10 horror stories in Paris, shot by 10 different directors, and Julia and me, and actually, a bunch of people were going to go back there and kill Julia. Because I didn't get to do that in Ireland so long, so I had to find a reason. Oliver, can I ask you questions? What do you think, what's your sort of view on the director's cut of this film?
Well, I think it has been really, really improved. I think it's a big, great experience. It's much more, I don't know, it feels more grown in a way, and it just makes it really fun to watch it. And I personally like also the length. I'm not sure how many minutes is it now exactly. It's
I think it's
exactly 150 some seconds or something like that.
No, it's just not perfect.
And we should really talk to our distributor and see if they maybe can have it bring it in cinema.
Yeah.
People really would enjoy it a lot.
And you can help. Send email to who? Just in any. No. Okay. A speed campaign.
Anybody.
And then go to our distributors in front of our house, you know, organize a demonstration. We'll get them. Maybe just a little joke for you guys. Okay, let's go for another couple of more questions. Then I'm going to let you go. There.
Did you do any re-editing of the special effects? Like in Star Wars?
No, we didn't. No, there's a couple of scenes which were sort of rushed, so basically we had to render them originally in a little bit lower grade. Not much, but you can see a little bit, too much artifacts in those scenes. So those we sort of re-rendered, but no, we didn't go fixing anything. I don't think that we didn't fix anything because, you know, it's flawless filming. I think something that is not broken is anything.
Yes, because on the map of Cos Life, you have translated United States of America as Vereinigte Zustände von Amerika.
That is funny because
Vereinigte Zustände.
Oh gosh. Oliver! You were there! I must admit to my friends, I don't speak enough. I'm learning bit by bit. I can say things now that I can talk to something, but really, I don't. So I was unfortunately, but that was intentional. So. You have to have something for those who actually, those fans are like mistake spotters.
Did you ever thought about a 3D version realized in 2014, maybe?
No, I have to say I have a bit of a problem with 3D. I don't enjoy 3D films. I think only with 48 frames per second it actually makes sense. Even then, it doesn't really add to the story. And I understand what's always. I think it needs to be. It doesn't. There's no reason you do the 3D first. I mean, I understand Avatar. I understand maybe Life of Pi. Other than that, it's just a marketing device, and I don't want to be that cheap. But yeah, honestly, that's so. I will not do. I promise you here. I won't do a 3D, you know, cheap 3D re-rendering of this film ever in my life, to ruin it, never in my life. That's a promise. Okay, let's do let me give two more questions. First is, there.
Yeah, hi. Just one question. I noticed you put TARDIS into one of the space battles. And I was wondering, were there any other sci-fi moments that we kind of missed.
Yeah. Did anybody else notice TARDIS? There's a couple of people, yeah.
And
it's the smallest couple of pixels there. In the deep space battle, the Doctor Who's space TARDIS is also joining the battle, of course. Doctor Who is always defending. Anyway, yeah, in the designs and bits and pieces, we've hit a lot of things, but I won't give them out that in a detail. I think it's fine to look through them and go through things, but there's a lot of hidden things. I think that's one thing which I like really much, sort of a nod to all these things that I've grown up with watching, you know, starting from Star Trek to Doctor Who to whatever. It's just a nice nod to these entities that I love and I want to put them in. But let's do one more. Last question, my friends. Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. Imagine that in 2018 the Moon Nazis are really coming here.
Yeah.
And don't you think that they will be really disappointed that everyone already knows?
I'm sorry. Well, wolf kind of wanted to make it. Okay, let's give last words to my friends over there. I'm going to put the microphone. Maybe you want to say a few words about, I don't know, whatever. The stage is yours.
Thank you very much. I guess at the moment, this has been fabulous, and I mean, we three producers still talk every week. It just is an ongoing thing with Nine Sky, and it's all great to be able to catch up with the team in person here. But it is very much that we've been talking about the sequel and the prequel, so it's quite exciting, and we're trying to work out how we can fit that in around everybody else's busy schedules. So, keep watch that space.
Yeah, what can I say? Well, thanks for coming. It's been really great that you guys have all been here. And it's really a wonderful anniversary. Exactly 1 year ago we were in Berlin with the film, and now it feels like it was yesterday. So it's a great being here, and thank you.
Yeah.
It's really great being here. Now we have to hurry to get something here in 1 year's time. I don't know.
Yeah, I just want to say thank you that you all came, like a fourth or fifth time. And yeah, it was truly a pleasure shooting it, because the guys are even more crazy in real life. Yeah, I'm looking forward for the sequel. Okay, enjoy the night.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much, everybody. If you want to get, I don't know, we have a couple of limited edition Iron Sky t-shirts, very cool Iron Sky game, and a fantastic, although we sold them out actually, so we don't have anymore. But anyway, Iron Sky game, Iron Sky board game, two things which are very easily acquirable over there. I thank you so much for coming here. Spread the good word for Iron Sky. Thank you, and have a good night. There's a bar there that they're selling beer, so if you want to stick around, grab a beer, you know, talk with us, we'll be there.
What's up,